Hello everyone, this is going to be a short lecture on material balance without chemical reaction, where I will talk about tie substance and how to handle problems where recycle operation is involved. So we are very well aware that a material balance problem requires the satisfaction of law of conservation of mass. This is the foremost criteria that you need to go through. Now, the mathematical expression, the general expression is rate of mass input plus rate of generation, if any, equals to rate of mass output plus rate of consumption plus rate of accumulation. This is the general law of conservation of mass expression that is applicable to any material balance problem, irrespective of whether it involves chemical reactions or not. But if there is no chemical reaction, then this law will reduce to a much simpler format, which is rate of mass in equals to rate of mass out. This is the simple format in which it will reduce. Now comes the point that what is a tie substance? So a tie substance is such a substance which occurs in an incoming stream and it occurs in one outgoing stream. What is the utility of having this tie substance? It will serve as a reference. When we want to calculate the stream values, be it the flow of the streams or the component mass in a given stream or the composition of a stream, if we know the tie substance, then we can make it act as a reference to perform further calculations. So I'll try to provide one example. Say we have a process where this is stream 1, which has x1a and x1b, that is the mole fractions of the components A and B. There's another incoming stream 2, which has C, and it is entirely comprising of C. There is one outgoing stream 3, which has X1A, I wrote the ID wrong, this is X3A. So the first initial is the stream number and the second initial is the component number, that is the order in which I am writing, X3A and X3B, and there is a fourth outgoing stream, which is X4A and X4C. Now, if we conduct an overall balance for this process, then we can write that M1 dot, let us consider that the mass flow rate is specified as M dot. So M1 dot, that is the mass flow rate of the first stream, plus m2 dot equals to m3 dot plus m4 dot. This is the overall balance. Since we are aware that this is the entirety of what goes into the process and this is what comes out of the process. Now coming to component balance, for component A we may write m1 dot x1a equals to m3 dot x3a plus m4 dot x4a. Because the component A enters through the first stream and leaves through streams 3 and stream 4. When I want to make the component balance of B, I can write m1 dot x1b equals to m3 dot x3b. So you can see clearly that B is coming into the system through one stream only and exits the system through one stream only. There is no other stream which carries B. For component C, we can write that M2 dot, that is the second stream in all its entirety, equals to M4 dot into X4C. This also, just like the previous case, as you can see, C component comes only through stream 2 and exits only through stream 4. So, as per the definition of type substance that we have just discussed, B and C are the tie components. Now, once these values are known, we can easily calculate the subsequent stream references, be it the composition value, be it the mass flow rate value. Now coming to the recycle operation, typically a process that has recycled would look somewhat like this. Let's say this is the fresh feed. And here we have a mixer. From this mixer, a total feed goes out. And why is it a total feed? We'll come to that point. This is the actual process. Maybe it is a reactor. This is the gross product. Why the term gross product is used, we'll come to that as well. This is a separator. And here we obtain the final product. From the separator, maybe some part of the unused feed is redirected back to the mixer. And this is what we call the recycle. So fresh feed plus the recycled portion together comprise the total feed. This total feed goes into the process and gives out the gross product. The gross product comprises of the actual product as well as a part of the unused feed. Now in the separator, the unused feed is separated and redirected back to the mixer, whereas the product is obtained as the outlet stream. Let us put some initials on this system so that we can understand even better. Let's call fresh feed F, the recycled stream as R, total feed T, gross product G, and final product P. Now, to understand how the streams balance each other, let us envelop each section. So in the first case, I want to envelop this entire process. Just making a bit of change. So this is the entire product. Now you can simply balance it as F is equals to P. So F enters this envelope and P exits this envelope. So this is the first overall balance that we obtain. Next, let us consider another envelope. Let us consider only this mixer as the main operation. So if we consider the mixer, you will see that the input streams, okay, let me write over here that this is the overall process. For the mixer, we can write F plus R equals to T. This is for the mixer. F plus R is the input to the mixer and T is the output from the mixer. Similarly, for the process, you can write T is equals to G. This is for the process. In the fourth part, for the separator, you can write that the gross product equals to P plus R. This is for the separator, where gross product G is the total input to the separator and P plus R together give the total output from the separator. So this is the simplest breaking up of the entire system. Now, when we actually solve a problem, we will consider the component balances in the same order and solve the system for the desired unknowns. Let us take a small example to understand this problem better. Let us consider a block diagram for the production of NaOH. So the block diagram looks somewhat like this. There is first an evaporator. This is a very popular example to introduce students to the concepts of material balance involving recycle and without any chemical reaction. So first of all, there is an evaporator, and then there is a crystallizer. So our target is production of NaOH flakes. Production of NaOH or sodium hydroxide flakes. Now, here we have a mixing point. The fresh feed F comes in over here. Here we obtain the product, gross product. Since this is the mixing point, here we should get the total feed. That is, some other stream comes and mixes over here, which is why we have a mixer. So I've just put this symbol for the mixer. We obtain the product over here, that is P. Now, some amount of water exits from this evaporator. Let us label it as W. This comprises totally of water. And from the crystallizer, the stream, the recycled stream of unused feed is fed at the mixing point. So this is the recycled stream R. Now it is given in the question that this fresh feed is of 10,000 pounds per hour, where NaOH is 40%. So the composition of NaOH is 40% by weight. This has been supplied for the fresh feed. In the gross product, it is said that this gross product has a composition of 50% NaOH. The recycle, or as the question terms it, the filtrate from the crystallizer has 45% NaOH. And the final product, P, that has 95% filter cake and 5% of it is the solution of NaOH, which is basically the filtrate. So a part of the filtrate moves out with the filter cake in the final product, but most part of the filtrate rushes back to the mixing point. Now our target is to determine all the unknown terms over here. So simply going by the logic, we can say that the overall balance is the fresh feed coming into the process, the water exiting from the process, and the product exiting from the process. This should give us the overall balance of the system. Overall balance simply means I am taking all these operations under a single envelope. The entire evaporator crystallizer operation under a single envelope. So this is what we are supposed to get. Now at the evaporator, F plus R, which is actually equals to T, since T enters the evaporator, this input is equivalent to W plus G as the output. Finally, okay, let me write over here that this is for the evaporator so that this does not cause any confusion later on. In the third part, we have G equals to P plus R. What is this for? This is for the crystallizer unit. That is, the entirety of the gross product is the input and the outputs are from the crystallizer, P and the R streams. Now simply what we do over here is we plug in the component balances from the known compositions. So for the first equation, we are very well aware that the fresh feed consists of 40% by weight of NaOH. So we may write that 0.4 into 10,000 LP per hour equals to water, and water does not have any NaOH. So we will write W into 0 plus the product stream has 95% of the filter cake and it has 0.5% filtrate, but sorry, not 0.5%, 5%, which is 0.05 fraction of the filtrate. As you can see here, 5% solution of NaOH or filtrate, Now this filtrate has a separate composition which is already supplied with the recycle stream. That is, the filtrate itself has 45% NaOH. So 5% of the 45%, that should give us the amount of NaOH in the filtrate part of the product. I hope this is clear to you. I'll just repeat it once again. In the component balance, since NaOH is the main component, let me write it over here. NaOH is the main component, so we are performing the component balance, and the fresh feed has 40% of NaOH, which is 40% of 10,000 pounds per hour. The first outlet stream is water, and water does not consist of any NaOH, so the fraction is zero. And P, the next stream which has NaOH, P, which has 95% filter cake, which is entirely NaOH, so 0.95. Also, it has 5% of filtrate. Now, 5% of this filtrate, we have been told that the filtrate itself consists of or is composed of 45% NaOH. So, the product actually has 0.05 multiplied by 0.45 fraction of NaOH from its filtrate part. Now, when we solve this equation, we should get that P is equals to 4113.110 lb per hour. Naturally, we can write F minus P equals to W, which is water is 5886.89 lb per hour. So we have already determined P and W. Now, let us see one thing. That is, for the second equation, we know that F plus R, that is 10,000 lb per hour plus R equals to water, which is 5886.89 plus the gross product. So, we can write that this gross product equals to 4113.110 plus R. Now, simply if you see, we were well aware that the gross product equals to P plus R, and again we have obtained the same thing. Gross product equals to this value is equivalent to P plus R. So we are pretty much on the right track. This is just another step to show that the satisfied overall stream balance. So we can proceed to the interior balances without any further hurdle. Now, going for the NaOH balance from this stream, so in the second stream itself, we can write that NaOH balance will be 0.4 into 10,000 plus 45% of the recycle. The recycle stream entirely comprises of filtrate, and 45% of the filtrate is the NaOH composition. So we can directly write 0.45 into R equals to 0.5 into G. Why are we writing 0.5 into G? Because here it's given that the gross product should have 50 weight percent of NaOH. So 0.5 into G. This is essentially the balance for our evaporator. Also, needless to say, for the water part, there will be no balance because the water does not comprise of any amount of NaOH in it. So whether you write it or not, it's immaterial as long as the rest of it is correct. Now, we are already aware that G can be written as 0.5 into 4113.110, which is the product, plus R. So now if you solve these equations, you should get something like 4000 plus 4000 plus 0.45 R equals to 2056.56. This is what I've obtained by calculation, plus 0.5 R. When you solve it, you should get R is equals to 38868.0 LV per R. So you have obtained all the important factors that you needed. You already know the feed, the fresh feed, that is F. You are already aware of it. So using this along with the water and product, from the overall balance you have calculated the product and you have obtained the water. After that, you have got from the second equation or the evaporator balance, what should be the value of R. Now, since you know F and R, you can calculate T. And since you know T and W, you can automatically calculate G. So all the parameters are now known for your problem. Now, sometimes question may be asked that what is the ratio of recycle to fresh feed? So you just simply have to put the values. This is a very common question, although it is more common in cases when you are having a chemical reaction involved in the process. So if such a question comes, you can easily calculate, once you have all the stream values, the ratio of recycle to fresh feed can be calculated. Sometimes the ratio of recycle to total feed is also asked. So please check when you answer what your question demands and put the values accordingly. As I said, the total feed value should be the sum of fresh feed and the recycle stream. So this is how you can easily solve the problems concerning recycle operation in material balance without chemical reaction. I'll just once again run through the gist. So first of all, we have material balance, which requires the satisfaction of law of conservation of mass. We have the general expression. After the general expression, for a process where no chemical reaction is involved, the material balance reduces simply to rate of mass in equals to rate of mass out. Then comes the concept of tie substance, that is the substance which occurs in only one incoming stream and one outgoing stream. It simply serves as a reference. Through a brief example, I have illustrated how the tie substance can be identified. Now, for a recycle operation, the general block diagram for a recycle operation and how the stream balances are performed, that has been illustrated. Finally, an example on the production of NaOH flakes, that is solved, wherein we have calculated the fresh feed, total feed, the gross product, the final product, and the recycled stream values. And I have also shown you the required performance indices, like recycle with respect to the fresh feed and recycle with respect to the total feed. These are some of the required performance indices or asked questions for examinations. So that is it for today. Thank you.